Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to create a post-process effect that detects heats. First, click the character blueprint to open the window. Next, click the Add Component button to create a post-process. Create an array by clicking Add Element in Post Process Materials in the Rendering Features section of Post Process. Next, choose to set it as an asset reference so that user material can be applied as a post process. After compiling the blueprint, return to the Content Browser window to create a material and click to open the window. Set material domain as post process. After creating two scene texture nodes, set one as custom depth and the other as scene depth. Next, create two component mask nodes and set them to one among red, green, and blue, and connect two scene texture nodes respectively. Next, create a subtract node, connect the component mask nodes to the subtract node like the video. Next, create a clamp node without changing the color and connect it with a subtract node. Next, create a 1- node and connect it to the clamp node after that, connect it to the emissive color of the material and save it. Go back to the post-process of the character blueprint, set the material created so far in the array of the post-process, and compile. Now, if you look at the level, the character will be white and everything else will be black except the character. Open the material window again. Holding down L on the keyboard and click to create a lerp node, hold the number 3 and click to create two constant 3 vector nodes. Next, holding down S on the keyboard, click to create a parameter node, and then create a Fresnel node. After setting the name and value of a parameter node, connect it to the Fresnel node. Then, connect the Fresnel node and two constant 3 vector nodes to the lerp node. Set color of the constant 3 vector nodes, one to navy color and the other to blue light color. Next, after creating a scene texture node, set the scene texture to world normal. Next, create a component mask and set red, green, and blue, connect it to the scene texture node, and connect it to normal in the Fresnel node. Next, copy the nodes connected to lerp node. Next, remove the lerp node among the copied nodes, create a 3-color blend, and create another constant 3-vector node. Set the colors to orange, fluorescent, and blue, including the created constant 3-vector node and the two copied constant 3-vector nodes. When the settings are completed, connect the constant 3 vector nodes and Fresnel nodes to the 3 color blend nodes like the video. After creating a Lerp node, connect the previously created Lerp, 3 color blend, and 1 minus nodes to the created Lerp node, and then connect it to the emissive node of the material. Now, save and go back to the content browser. You will see that the camera is detecting the heat of the character. Now, to create the noise effect, enable engine content by clicking Show Engine Content in the View options at the bottom right of the Content Browser window. Then, go back to the Material window and create a texture sample node by holding down T on the keyboard and clicking on it, and set it as the blue noise texture in the engine content. After creating a text chord node, create a multiply node and a parameter node. Set the name and value of the parameter node to adjust the noise scale. Connect the text chord node and the parameter node to the multiply node. Next, create a panner node and set the node speed X and Y values to about 1.5. Next, connect the multiply node to the panner node, then connect the panner node to the texture sample node so the texture can move diagonally. Next, create a multiply node and a parameter node once more and connect the created parameter node to the multiply node after setting the name and value like the video. And connect the blue channel of the texture sample to the multiply node. Next, create an add node by clicking with the text chord node and keyboard A. Connect the text chord node and the multiply node to the add node. Connect each add node to the UV of the scene textures with the world normal. Now, save and go back to the content browser, and you can see the noise effect added to the character. If you want to apply heat detection to other characters or objects, check Render Custom Depth Pass in the rendering section of the object you want to apply.